Officer Courtney Scott from Eastman YDC is going to deliver our invocation.
Good morning.
Ma'am. Good morning, ma'am.
Dear Heavenly Father, we bless your name. Only because of you we have made it to this day. Please forgive us all of our sins and iniquities. Lord, we invoke your name and your presence this day. Be with us as we go forth in this ceremony. May your presence fall upon us and our families. May you bless every leader, instructor, officer, and state official in their respectful places. Bless Class 250 as we set out to do your will with the gift you have provided. May no weapon formed against us, our families, and our careers prosper. Lord, give us your unmerited favor, love, peace, joy, and strength. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Deputy Director Dr. Tania Applin will present the welcome.
It is indeed an honor and a awesome blessing to be able to greet you all this morning for this awesome celebratory achievement for our JCOs for BJCOT Class 250. To our Commissioner Tyrone Oliver, to our Deputy Commissioner, Ms. Deputy Commissioner Hill, also Deputy Commissioner Wolf. We are really excited to have each one of you here this morning. Thank you for your attendance and for your continued support of our BJCOT program here at the DJJ Training Academy. We would be remiss if we didn't say good morning and thank you to our board chairman, that of Sandra Heath Taylor, and of course our vice chairman is here as well, Willie Bolton, who is always so supportive of our programs. Thank you, Mr. Bolton, for being here. I would be remiss to not thank our DJJ family and welcome them as well. So, DJJ family, thank you so much for being here. Thank you for allowing the support to provide us so that we can make sure that your cadets, now your officers, will be prepared to do the work that you need them to do. So, thank you. And you know what? I would be remiss to not thank our BJCOT coordinator, Mr. Anthony Hubbard, in his absence this morning. He is working down at the range this morning, so we're going to keep our fingers crossed about that. Yeah, yeah. Also, to the additional instructors in that program, thanks to each one of them, all of our adjunct instructors, of course, to Jason, our assistant director. We have so many people to welcome and thank this morning, so I'm done welcoming people, so now welcome. Welcome, welcome. But what I want to say to this class, and we had a great discussion on yesterday, and I just want to add one piece to that discussion that we talked about on yesterday. You know, we talked about how we had this awesome opportunity to be able to make a kid turn his life all the way around. But I want to make just one small adjustment to that. I think instead of just doing a 360, our job is just to turn them 90 degrees. Because if they turn all the way back around to 360, they're back where they started at, right? So we don't want to do that. We want to do 90 degrees. And then we'll let our probation officers do the other 90, right? So we are a team. And so I want to kind of correct that a little bit from yesterday, because if remember what we talked about, if we give them our listening ear and a kind heart, that makes a big difference in the lives of these children that we're working. I can say that because I saw that young lady I was telling y'all about yesterday at the nail shop. So she's like, hey. But anyway, again, small turn. So I want to leave that with you all. I want you all to be just so enthusiastic about the success of others as you are about your own, to forget about those mistakes of the past and to press on to greater achievements for the future, to wear that cheerful countenance always and give every living creature you meet that beautiful DJJ smile. So remember, you can and you will make the difference because you are the change that DJJ needs. Congratulations and welcome. So Ms. Stephanie Hardnett from the Rockdale RYDC will introduce our keynote speaker, Mrs. Felicia Cobb, Assistant Director of Programs at Wilkes, RYDC.
Good morning.
Ma'am, good morning, ma'am.
Our keynote speaker, Ms. Felicia Cobb, started her career with the state of Georgia in 1997 in the Department of Corrections at Baldwin State Prison as a mental health secretary. She transferred to the community side of the Department of Corrections in 2000, working at the Northeast Region Probation Office. In 2002, Felicia transferred to the Greensboro Probation Office as an accountant paraprofessional. After working with adults for 21 years, Felicia decided to transfer to the Department of Juvenile Justice as the Administrative Operations Manager at Wilkes RYDC in 2018, and was later there promoted to Assistant Director of Programs. Felicia enjoys giving back to her community. She served on the Greene County Board of Education for 12 years. In addition to her service to the Greene County school system, Felicia was an active member of the Greene County branch of the NAACP, serving as treasurer, member of education committee, and the chairperson of the organization's Freedom Fund Banquet. She also has served as a committee member and sponsor of the county's annual Back to School Bash, mentor and financial coach at Atlas Ministry, and Sunday school teacher at Hill Chapel Baptist Church. After serving on the school board, Felicia felt that if she was going to continue to encourage the youth in her community, she had to live by example. So she went back to school and earned her associate's degree in business administration from the Georgia Military College and enrolled in Valdosta State, where she earned a bachelor's degree in organizational leadership and also completed governmental accounting through the University of Georgia. Felicia and her husband are co-owners of J. Ray Trucking, LLC, a flatbed trucking company that services southeastern states. She is also the founder and owner of Felicia & Company, an event decor and catering business. Felicia is married to Raymond Cobb, and they are the parents of four children, Whitney, Tawny, Raquel, and Jalen. They have three grandchildren, Tyler, Tiger, and Harper. Felicia lives by the motto of treating others of how they want to be treated. Please join me in welcoming Ms. Felicia Cobb, our keynote speaker.
Thank you so much for that introduction. Good morning.
Ma'am. Good morning, ma'am.
First, I would like to thank my Heavenly Father for allowing me to stand before you all today. And believe me, without him, this wouldn't be possible, because this is something new. I'm coming out of my shell speaking in front of people. I would like to thank the Academy leadership for having me here today. I would like to thank the Commissioner Oliver, D.C. Hill, D.C. Wolf, the chaplain that's here, especially Mr. Bolden, our board member, any of the regionals and the directors or assistant directors that's here in the audience. I want to thank you all for your support and your leadership. Last but not least, I would like to thank BJCOT Class 250 for having me here today in your time. Congratulations, BJCOT Class 250. You have accomplished a great milestone in your life. Now that you have completed 6 weeks of hard, tedious training, you are now ready to lead our youth. I know you might be saying to yourself, well, I'm not in a leadership position. But regardless of your position, we are all leaders. Whether we are director leading a facility or an assistant director leading security or programs, even as a lieutenant, you are leading a key, and your sergeant is there who's looking to you for guidance. Even as a sergeant, your JCOs, they're looking to you for guidance. And as a JCO, your youth, the youth inside the facility is looking to you for guidance. So we are all leaders with a common goal to transform young lives by providing evidence-based rehabilitative treatment, services, and supervision, strengthening the well-being of youth and families, and fostering strong communities. Believe me when I tell you this, that the youth at your facility, they're going to watch your every move. They're going to see how you interact with your coworkers. They're going to watch and listen to how you respond to your supervisors. If the youth hear you being disrespectful to your supervisors, or if they hear you talking bad about your coworkers or even your supervisors, then they would take on and say, well, I can treat them that way too. So I advise you to lead by example. We might not all agree with one another, but when we're inside of those gates, we got to show that unity so we can accomplish the mission of DJJ. We're here to change the lives of these youth so they won't come in and reoffend. My motto in life is to treat others how you want to be treated. I know some people might feel that these youth might deserve to be locked up, but I want you all to realize that we could have been in that position sometime in our life. It is important to lead with grace and empathy in your new role. You have the opportunity to change a life or two. So lead by example. Great leaders, they don't set out to be a leader. They set out to make a difference. Remember, it is never about your role, it is always about your goal. This motto here is what helps me and reminds me of my purpose on my tough days at work. And I will tell you, and I'm going to be honest with you, you will have some days that's harder than others. Our former chief of staff, Mr. Mark Mitchell, he sent out this quote with his daily birthday wishes one day, and it really stood out to me. And I printed it out, and I put it up on my board, and I looked at that. I look at it every day. And before I got promoted, it says, leaders with influence. They give when they don't have to. They care for others. They grow the community. They live authentically. They empower others. They manage hardship, and they serve humility. I encourage each one of you to be a leader with influence. Be that change agent that will help our fellow coworkers and inspire the youth to be better. We might be the only positive influence that they might see. So let's try to be that motivator, that encourager, that example for them. I will leave you with this one last quote. Every job is a self-portrait of the person that do it. Autograph your work with excellence. I am so proud of your accomplishment and the start of your new career. Be the leader that you're so well capable of being. The sky is the limit. Grow as an individual, grow as a leader, and I would like to say thank you for your time. Thank you, DJJ Leadership. Thank you, Academy Leadership, and y'all have a blessed day. Thank you.
Deputy Director Dr. Tania Applin will now present special awards.
These weeks, you all have worked very, very hard and have met several different challenges, some of you more than others, and you know, I all told you how proud I am of each and every one of you. And these challenges are the examples of the things that you may encounter when working within our agency, with our kids, with our staff, and even with the community. And so guess what? You have accomplished this goal. And so we're here this morning to honor and recognize the excellent job that the cadets have done over the course of these couple of weeks. And during the program, students complete several written and practical tests. Yes? Yes, okay. The academic tests are averaged to produce the student's grade point average. And the highest achievement award belongs to the student who achieves the highest grade point average. So ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to present the highest academic achievement award for this BJCOT class 250 to Courtney Scott with the grade point average of 92. She is from Eastman, YDC. Okay. And so now Deputy Commissioner Pamela Hill will now present the Reinhardt Scholarship Award and graduatory comments.
So good morning again, Class 250.
Good morning.
Okay. So we're excited to be a participant in the Reinhardt University Scholarship Program. Our collaboration is designed to further develop our staff professionally and personally. The Reinhardt Scholarship Award is presented today to Ms. Courtney Scott from Eastman YDC. Congratulations, Ms. Scott. And so while I'm up here, Ms. Applin, Dr. Applin has given me the opportunity to just say some congratulatory comments to you all. I just want to say we really appreciate you all for your dedication in choosing Georgia Department of Juvenile Justice as a career. We need you. We're looking for longevity in you. And we're just looking for you to go back and do great things at your facility. And I'll be seeing you around. Thank you and take care.
We will now present certificates to BJCOT Class 250.
Class, attention!
Marlena Abernathy, Bob Richards, RYDC. Christopher Adams, Ilbert Shaw, RYDC. Shantese Carter, Martha K. Glaze, RYDC. Jeremy Coley, Metro, RYDC. Eldora Davis, Macon, YDC. Stephanie Harnett, Rockdale, RYDC. Marion Hawkins, Macon, YDC.
Ashira. You Shira. Mm-hmm.
That's bad luck. All right. You Shira Hawkins, Macon, RYDC. Stephen Hill, Eastman, YDC. Shatika Morrell,
Chris, RYDC. Adrian Meyer, Bob Richards, RYDC. Latanya Neal, Aaron Cohen, RYDC. Lisa Poff, Macon, YDC. Jessica Randolph, Muskogee, YDC.
Rinkin?
Laura Rinkin, Elbert Shaw, RYDC. Kenneth Romero, Muskogee, YDC.
Desiree.
Desiree Schultz, Savannah, RYDC. Courtney Scott, Eastman, YDC. Venetia Smith, Venetia Smith, Macon, RYDC. Kanika Walker, Atlanta, YDC. Patrice Williams, Marietta, RYDC. Another round. Good job. During BJCOT, our officers work to listen, participate, and learn the duties of their job. The officers begin to form common bonds through various life experiences and overcoming many obstacles as they find themselves no longer an individual among the many, but part of a team. Graduation is an opportunity to hear from the class through class comments, so it's now my pleasure to introduce Officer Kenneth Romero from Muskogee YDC, who will give reflections for BJCOT Class 250.
Good morning.
Sir, good morning, sir.
As we reflect on these past 5 weeks, we came together as a diverse group of people with all different personalities. For some, it took a while, but we became friends and learned to work as a team. We would learn together and grow together. We all came here with one common goal, and that was to get to this day and become a certified juvenile correctional officer. Thanks to all of our instructors for pushing us to the max and holding everyone accountable for their actions and guiding us for all the way to success. If not for their guidance and instructions, we wouldn't be sitting before you today. The path to success wasn't easy, but we are here standing tall and proud, ready for the challenges that await each one of us. Class 250 is grateful for the opportunity to receive basic juvenile correction officers training and become the best DJJ officers we can be. Our experience here was one for the books. So thank you, Class 250. We did it. On behalf of the BJCOT Class 250, I want to present this plaque not only to our instructors and directors, but to everyone who was involved in why we are here today. With your guidance and shared knowledge, we are now officially equipped to enter our facilities with the dedication and strength we need to live out the DJJ mission.
Thank you again for all of your support. I would like to present to you BJCOT Class 250, our now newest basic juvenile correctional officers, certified juvenile officers.
Well, good morning. First, congratulations to Class 250. I just want to just thank all of you all in the room to come and support Class 250, and especially thanks to the Academy staff for preparing these men and women to go out and do good work. And I know it's being recorded, so I just want to just thank your families. Give them a round of applause, too, for supporting you through this five-week process. I don't think I can say anything that's already been said today. Ms. Cobb did a wonderful job in her speech, and so I won't take too long, but I just want to just, again, congratulate you for joining the DJJ family. You're going to have a difficult job, but a very important job, and just like Dr. Appling said, you know, we're going to be that, you all are that positive influence that these young people have. A lot of times they come from, you know, backgrounds or families or communities that don't have that positive influence, but you can be that positive influence, that positive role model. So remember, we're not going to turn them three all the way around, right? We're just going to do that 90 degrees. But if you can go 180, do that 180 too, because, you know, probation may not, they may not be on probation to go out. And so just do all that you can for these young people, because that's what we're charged to do, to transform their lives, and they need you. The state of Georgia needs you. And again, just thank you for joining the DJJ family. Have patience, stick with us. It's a tough job, but it's a very rewarding job. I sat in your seats back in 1999 as I started off in the adult system. So it's very rewarding career. And I just wanted to thank you for joining DJJ. And again, thank you, Mr. Bolton, for always supporting us and supporting the class here at the Academy. But again, congratulations, and I'll see you out there in the field soon. Take care.
Let us pray together. Almighty God, thank you for the power of leadership in our commissioner, our board, our present board chair, and in Mr. Willie Bolden. Thank you for the mighty things that you are doing through the people that you have sent. Thank you for the power of leadership, of service, of each officer that you sent to do the sacred duty of redeeming the youth in our care. May they continue to be a support to one another. May we be the support to them. And may your reward be sure. In your holy name, amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please rise for the retirement of colors and for the officer's recession? Congratulations to Class BJCOT 250. This concludes our graduation ceremony. Y'all have a blessed weekend.